good evening and welcome to a very special edition of Tunic Outdoors, because this time I've been waiting for this moment probably all my life. Actually gonna go to Canada with James on an expedition with the one and only Todd Standing. I'm going tomorrow morning. It's all booked. This trip's been in the making for about 3 years. So the way it all started was, I was going to take James to Disneyland, Florida, and paid for everything. We got it all booked. Everything was sorted. And then obviously the lockdown happened. We couldn't go to Florida. And during that period of lockdown is probably when I, like everybody else, probably started watching all the YouTube videos. And I always had an interest in Sasquatch anyway, ever since I was a kid. Used to watch Arthur C. Clarke's Mysterious World and loved all the Loch Ness and UFO Sasquatch and that. And I loved the Patterson-Gimlin film. And I did actually wonder whether it was real like everybody else. It's great footage, and it's, I think people have tried to debunk it many, many times. And over the periods of where we've developed with technology and what have you, it's pretty obvious it's real. You can see the muscle definition, you know, the way it moves, its gait, it's just gliding along over rough terrain, and it's a beast, you know. So and it was female. I mean, who'd think of doing that back then, you know? So yeah, so during that lockdown, me and James, we watched a lot of Bigfoot documentaries, and we ended up watching Todd Standing's film, Discovering Bigfoot. And just totally hooked with it, and just thought, who is this character? He's so brave. He just goes out on his own, and he's like in the wilderness, you know, boots on the ground, just getting out there and doing it. And he did this film, and it was just amazing. And it was like, me and James were captivated. When we finished watching it, we were like, let's watch it again. Let's watch it again. It's brilliant, you know. And James took a real interest, and during the lockdown, there was not much to do other than just watch telly and play on the PlayStation like everybody else, you know. And he came up with this project. He was going to do like a book that describes Bigfoot and explains a bit about it and where it comes from, what, you know, evidence that's been brought to the attention, what Todd Standing's done, what other researchers have done, footage, you know, and started really going in detail. And he was getting photographs, and he ended up coming out with a pretty decent book. And I said, why don't we send it to Todd, see if, not thinking he'd ever get it, you know. We just sort of like, we seen he had a mailbox, and we sent it to him. And we were watching his shows every other week. He was doing a show, and lo and behold, pulled this book out, and it was like, mentioned James, and you know, we were just gobsmacked, you know. I didn't think he would get this this book, so I was really proud. And yeah, Todd was really, like, you know, impressed with what James had done. James was only like sort of 11 or 12 at the time. And yeah, so in the comments on the YouTube channel, I just said, oh, I'd love to come on an expedition with you. And he replied, he said, well, why not just do it? Come out here. And I thought, oh my God, we could actually do this, you know. So obviously, because we'd not done Florida and felt like I'd let James down a little bit, I thought, let's do it. You know what I mean? I've always wanted to go to Canada. We had the invite from Todd, and yeah, so we did the online application. We ended up to and fro him with messages and what have you, and he said, yeah, I'll take you and your son, and I'll take my son, and we'll go on a father and son expedition. So yeah, we had it planned for later that year. We're going to go in August of that same year, not knowing how long the lockdown's going to last for, but obviously they lasted a bit longer than that, so we couldn't get into the country. That ended up getting cancelled. So it's like, well, let's do perhaps go the next year. Can we do the same time next year? Yeah. And they were giving out the injections, the vaccines, the poison, you know, and James was supposed to have his in school and he didn't because there was some, I think there was COVID within the school, so they had to, they couldn't do the jabs when they should be doing them. So he didn't get his jab, and then before we know it, it was coming up to like sort of August again. And right, you've got to have your two jabs to get into the country. I'm like, oh no, I forgot to give James his jabs. So he had one jab, and then we had to leave it 12 weeks before he could have another one, and that was going to surpass the time. You know, we weren't going to make it in time because we planned to do the same time. It was about a month away, and we needed to leave it 12 weeks. So that got scuppered, and we didn't end up doing it. I'd had an operation on my knee as well, so I'd had an ACL operation on my knee, and it didn't feel quite right, you know, to be hiking around Canada when I've got a bit of a dodgy knee. So Todd quite kindly said, well, let's do it next year, you know, the Sabre are not going anywhere. And we're like, oh, that's brilliant, yeah. So and that time has arrived now, so I've had like about 18 months recovery from the knee operation. Luckily, they're not pushing the poison anymore, so didn't get James his second jab, and if I'd have known what I know now, I wouldn't have had mine, to be honest. So anyway, that's another story. So we're going, we've got the passports, had to reapply for a passport, we're all packed, we're ready to go. I'm going to take you with me, and I'll probably have to break this down into maybe a few different shows, because I can imagine there's going to be a lot of footage, photographs and film while we're out there. We're out there for 8 days, so I hope my phone doesn't die. I've got like 4 power packs, and I'll try and document as much as I can, and then upload it when I get back. So yeah, keep posted, and hopefully I'll see you when I get back. We're here on the flight now. I just wanted to show you this, how good this is. Like, we're about halfway there now. See that? Is this? It's Todd's 4x4. It's James. Are you excited?
Oh yeah. Nervous, but excited.
I'm a bit nervous, I must admit, yeah. You know, don't know what to expect, but yeah. Then we're gonna be heading over into the mountains. We'll just get some fuel now before we go off road, and then we're going into the mountains and setting up a tent and see how it goes. It's beautiful. Anyway,
up this hill, and that's the Brazeau River.
Wow.
It's a nice one. And I start spinning my tires, and I'm spinning, and I start sliding backwards.
Oh.
I'm going into the Brazeau! Look how steep this hill is.
Oh, wow.
I literally made it almost to the top.
It needs some good tread.
Yeah, so I was with Expeditioners, and luckily I got one of them to hold the trailer brake. Well, another one held the brake, and I went up and put chains on the tire of my truck.
Oh my
god. And then we made it the rest of the way up the hill. And we ripped the shit out of this hill. I had chains like 3-inch studs on them, and we were like literally iced. Can you imagine coming up this hill, like half this speed? My tires are spinning 30 kilometers an hour, and we're going 5.
Yeah.
And just ripping ice out the back. The truck end was like almost coming up off the ground. We make it, boys! Sheer ice.
This is our second day in Canada. It's a beautiful day, look at it. It's James. That's the tent we put up last night. We got here about 9:30, 10 o'clock. It was going dark, so we managed to set that up. 8-man tent between us. And it was quite comfortable. We've got... Tad's brought some blow-up mattresses, so we blew the mattresses up. We all had a sleeping bag each, and it was nice. Didn't hear too many sounds during the night. I did kind of panic and wake up about... I don't know what time it was. But with a sudden realisation that I'm actually in the middle of nowhere in Canada. And it just hit me like a ton of bricks. And I was like, I was half panicking and just half appreciative, you know. So anyway, I think it's more appreciative. Look at it, it's beautiful. Todd's just had his drone up and he's had a good look up around the area. And it's just vast. It's just pine forests everywhere. And I think we're going to have a little walk up a trail in a bit, behind the tent. That's where Jeff Meldrum saw a Sasquatch, over the top of that. Just see it behind me. That mound is where Jeff Meldrum saw a Sasquatch run from these woods up there to that. And all the footprints were there. So we're going to go and check that out, and apparently there's some structures in these forests as well. But that forest road takes you to a nice little river that hopefully we're going to have a little ice bath in. We've already eaten a few little wild berries this morning. So, it's all good. See you later.
Is it Texas? I'm going to punch you in the face. Logan does better than I do. And he's got no training. He lived in a hot, crazy state.
What can you say?
How cold does it feel?
What can you say? What can you say, James?
What can you say?
James is going to go for an ice bath, well, we all are. And this is the river we're going to do it in. Look at that. It is crystal clear. So let's see how hard we are, James. Let's see whether...
Proper northern.
Lads from St. Helens can do this.
Come on.
We'll see. Gonna give it a go, best shot. Gotta do it while you're here, aren't you?
What do you figure, Stu? Go for a dunk?
Let's do it.
I'm recording.
Oh
man. Woo! Freaking Canadian glacier water. No problem. He's from Northern England, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Not one of those Southern, we won't say the names.
That Southern pussy.
Out here in the beautiful mountains.
Knee just cracked then. I think it's feeling, it's getting better.
Okay, so we found loads of tree breaks, and this is James's drink bottle. But this is the biggest print we found up to now.
And I'd say a good 14 inches.
It goes really deep in there as well, so the toes go my fingers are 3 inches. It's going in. And you can see how wide it is. And that print caused that tree break up there. That's what we're thinking. See if I can just get a better view of it. There it is. Power. It's got to be 3 inches, is it? 3 or 4 inches?
That's 3.5 to 4 inches at the top there.
Yeah.
100%. That's huge.
And we found loads today. This place is amazing. Look over there. Sunset. What time is it now? About 9 o'clock.
It is. Let's have a look forward. Half nine. So back at home, it is about 4:45 in the morning. I think we're adjusting pretty well, to be honest.
4:45? That can't be right.
Yeah, it's 7 hours, isn't it?
4:45.
Oh right, yeah. Sorry.
Yeah, so our body clocks are still
adjusting a little bit. But yeah, right.
But that ice bath we had today was nice, wasn't it?
Oh,
we basically got in this river, not here, but further down that way. It was freezing. But persevered with it, and I ended up getting my head under. So Todd was really impressed. Mm. Anyway, so good. This is like utopia, isn't it?
Oh.
Oh, no. You don't need to look so appalled. I take care of it all. It's medicine now. Don't pick up, I just called to say I'm happy as can be. I'm melting away. Drifting through the halls and hide us above. Have I really lowered the bar? Or am I working hard and spurring?